All right. We have got Aaron Shirk, Meds, Leal Collette. We got Leal Collette on the vocals. We got a live Proximity release. I think I've heard one drop of this on accident before, because I think I saw an Instagram clip from Aaron, and he put it in there when he did like a show or something like that. So I think I accidentally heard one. Yes. Gorgeous, gorgeous instrument. What was I gonna say? Gorgeous verses so far. Nice claps. Dude, her vocals, man. Oh my god, this is, you can already tell it's gonna be so good. Come on! Yeah, this is the drop I've heard. The lead in the back. Yas, dude. Okay, we got a second drop. What? Dude. Oh, brings in the melody. Dude. I mean, this is better than Used to Love so far. Holy shit, dude. Nice work, guys. Great vocals. Really nice complimenting verse production. Super full sound in both drops. What are we gonna get in the next ones, man? Are we gonna get something different? Oh my god, what are we gonna get? Oh, is it Psytrance? Oh, let's... Oh my gosh, let's go, dude! Oh, and things like the halftime there, nice! Oh, and we got a fourth drop? Melodic again? Nah! Stop! Oh, dude! The high-pitched lead! Oh my god! Holy shit! God damn, what the fuck, dude? Nah, hold up. Oh my god, nah! What the fuck have you guys done? Four different drops. Like all, and I just want to preface, I'm not saying this just because they're here. I would have reacted the same way regardless. That was fucked. God damn. You guys fucking nailed it, man. Holy shit. Like, what do I even say? Like, fantastic Leal Collette vocals.
great verse production, like the arps, like the lead there. Oh, like the, it was like the filtered lead in like the first verse was so euphoric. First drop, the lead and the saws just sound so full. Second drop, the dubs, like the dubstep sounded fantastic too. And then the psytrance, you had like the halftime, blended the energy in there a little bit. And then the fourth drop, like it was pretty similar to the first one, but the high pitch lead like elevated it and like gave it this like final send off. Holy shit, man. Dude, that's gonna end in my top 50. 100%. Probably top 20 at minimum. Top 20 at minimum. God damn, that's the best song I've heard this year. Hands down. I'm gonna give that a 9.5 on first listen. That's a 9.5 on first listen. That was damn good. Damn good. It just plays right into what I've been listening to lately too. I've been listening to like so much hybrid stuff lately. Lots of like Requiem's been a song I've listened to so much. So like just hearing a great vocal performance, great verses blend in with this sound I've just been into so much. That's just a perfect song for me right now, man. Damn. Good work. Good fucking work. That's the best song I've heard this year. I love how each drop are unique in their own way. That's how melodic dubstep should be. I'm loving the hybrid sound, man. Like, I would love to see more artists adopt that kind of, you know, hybrid style. Even if it's, like, two melodic drops, like, finding ways to make it unique, like, that fourth drop. I don't want to say it's easy, but there's, like, it takes very little, in my opinion, to impress me on just a different sounding drop. I cannot even begin to tell you how long it took to work on that one. Dude, you can tell the work got put into that one, man. You can tell the work got put into that. You guys did a fantastic job. That was awesome. So unique, has like three genres and the vocals are beautiful. Yeah. What else can you say? Like, it's not even like it's like an amazing, like, you know, innovative tune and the vocals kind of hold it back a little bit. Like, the vocals are fantastic too. Like, shit, man. I don't know. Is that top five? Is that top five this year? Psytrance is the best thing to happen to melodic dubstep. Prove me wrong. I would join you in that battle. I would stand by your side in arguing that, man. Psytrance is definitely one of the best things that's happened to this genre. I remember when I first used to hear Psytrance, I was like, fucking seriously? Come on. Psytrance, give me the same melodic dubstep drop. That was like in like 2020. 2019, not 2020, more like 2019. And then like, what was the track that changed my mind on that? I think Requiem. Requiem was probably the big one that was where I was like, oh shit, this is probably going to be a thing for a while. Reason for Fighting came out last year. Amazing. That's probably the best psytrance drop I've ever heard in Reason for Fighting. That first, oh, Naked Soul. How could I forget that one? Are you serious? I'm just casually avoiding one of the best songs of all time. Applause for the boys. We can give a little round of applause.